Welcome to Plano Police Department's True Crimes with Officer Bionis, a podcast dedicated to learning how criminals select their targets and what you can do to not be a victim. During each program, police officer, crime prevention specialist, and certified speaking professional, Chris Bionis teams up with a safety expert to discover crime trends and how you can protect yourself. Because that's what this podcast is all about, increasing the safety for you, your family, identity, and property. It's Plano Police Department's True Crimes with Officer Bionis. Take it away, Chris.
Detective Tony Vidmar, welcome back.
Thank you. I appreciate you having me back.
So what are we talking about today?
Chris, we're going to be talking about business email compromises.
Why would that be important to anyone who's listening or viewing this podcast?
With business email compromises, your potential to lose a lot of money.
Big bucks.
Big bucks.
Okay.
Do you have a true crime story that affected someone in Plano that you could share?
I have a couple of cases, Chris, that we're going to talk about today. The first one is where this company, it's a large company here in Plano, they lost about $350,000 in a matter of 10 minutes.
Ooh, that is a lot of money.
A lot of money.
So how did it happen?
So, Chris, with this company, they have about 280 small businesses that they manage. They're a group for a fast food chain. And so with this company, the company is here in Plano. However, the 280 businesses that are in this group are spread out throughout the country. So accounts payable received an email who they believed was from one of their CFOs stating, hey, we need to send a wire transfer of this money to X, Y, and Z. So the accounts payable got the email, saw that the person's name was the CFO with the address, with the email address, and thought that everything was okay. And they ended up wiring the $350,000 to this bank overseas. Then shortly after that, they got another email saying, we didn't receive those funds, you need to wire it again. So they were asking for another $350,000. At that point, the accounts payable person said, something's now not right. They made a phone call, which led to finding out that the CFO did not send that email to their accounts payable, and that money had been wired off overseas.
Oh, terrible. So where did the money actually, it just went to some, they gave him some random overseas account?
Yes. So they ended up getting instructions on how to wire the money overseas. Mm-hmm. And with that instructions on, this is what you do, this is how we want it, this is the bank that you send, et cetera. And that person believing that the email that they received mm-hmm. Was in fact from the CFO.
So the big caution is you send money overseas and to the wrong people, you're not getting that money back?
No, you're not.
Okay, so let's talk about tactics. How did they successfully extract $350,000 from this company?
By one letter.
What do you mean one letter?
So when accounts payable received an email who they believed was from the CFO requesting that this $350,000 be sent, they believed that by the email they were looking at that they see all the time, they see the CFO's name, and they correlate that because of correspondence back and forth. They didn't realize that in one letter of that person's name had been removed. And so the scammer had set up a new email address with that change in name by one letter. So the accounts payable believed that they were conversing with the CFO when in fact they were conversing with our suspect. And he or she was able to extract that $350,000 on one letter.
Oh, this is a good scam because some people might not want to check back with the CFO or CEO and say, do you really want this? Right? When they're told to do something, they want to just do it.
Yes.
So how do you ensure you don't make that mistake?
You've got to do your due diligence. Anytime that you're going to send funds, especially with business, and I do understand that that if you are to slow down every single time that you have to pay a bill, it does become time consuming. But when it's out of the ordinary, you're being asked to send funds that are typically you don't ever send, especially with something that large. I had asked the accounts payable lady, hey, is this the largest amount you've ever wired? And she goes, absolutely. She goes, normally it's something a lot smaller.
So that right there should have been a red flag that this is the first time that she is actually sending funds of that amount. That should have been a clue itself
to maybe go ahead and make a phone call. And with that, Chris, you know how like on some of the other scams that I told you that you have somebody on the other line pressuring you to immediately get things done. Some of these emails are of the same way. It's pressure. Hey, we need this funds immediately. We have to pay X, Y, and Z. We've got contractors here waiting to be paid. We need this. We need that. I don't have time to explain. I need this done.
Sense of urgency.
And you see that in almost every scam. It's always a sense of urgency that it needs to be done immediately. And it keeps you as you wanting to be a good employee to get this thing done and get it done immediately because there's people waiting on it.
What's this type of scam called again?
This is called a business email compromise.
Do you have another story like this?
So we have basically almost the same thing where this company lost $770,000. Okay, so now if you think about it, we're well over $1 million just on two scams, and it's basically the same thing. It's a large construction company, and they are doing business abroad and this and that. Well, the CFO was overseas, legitimately overseas doing business, and they got an email who they believed was the CFO saying that you needed to wire money to Dubai because I am getting ready to buy a bunch of equipment over there. We're going to start a new business. So the account's over here, and it was a nice detailed email. Everything looked legitimate. It had letterhead. It had all of this. They believe that they were dealing with the CEO of the company, and he said, I'm out of pocket. You can't call me. The internet is sketchy, telephone service is bad, but I need this done. Here are the instructions. His company, not doing their due diligence, wired that money off. And eventually they were able to get a hold of him after the money had transferred. He goes, I never asked for that. Once again, it was off by a couple of letters on the email address.
Change the email address.
As simple as that.
Wow. Well, valuable information. Watch those emails carefully, especially if they're asking you to do something out of the ordinary and if it involves a lot of money.
Yes.
Detective Tony Vidmar, thank you for joining us today.
It's always my pleasure. Thank you so much.